Hi guys, welcome to WebSense Pro. Welcome to another tutorial video. And in this video, we will show you guys how you can add stacked card animation effect on your WordPress website. So if you are a developer, a WordPress developer using Elementor, you can use this tutorial to create a stylish looking stacked card animation for your website, just like this. So when I scroll down, you can see these cards are going up. And when I scroll up, they are coming back to their position. Cool, right? So if you want to learn how to build this, please watch the complete video. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel, comment in the video below. And without further ado, let's get into the tutorial.
Hi guys, welcome back to WebSense Pro. I'm your co-host Nadeshik with another tutorial on Elementor. In this tutorial, I'll show you how you can make the stack card design on your Elementor website. So when you scroll down, the card starts to go away and the next one will show up at the very top. Also, when you scroll up, they again start to come back to the right place. In this way, you can make a beautiful service section or portfolio section design by following my tutorial. Okay, so now you guys can see that I've added a new page here. What I'll do is, I'll tell you step by step how you can make the stack card scrolling effect in your WordPress website. So first step is to add this container here, this direction column. I'll be adding a direction column here. I'll change its width to full width from the left side and min height to VH first. And then I'll make it 100. Looks good. Go to style and give it a nice background color. From background type, you can choose from the color palette. Okay, this looks good. Now quickly, I'll choose this icon here and drag a heading widget first. Okay, and again, we'll choose this icon from the left side and I'll search for an icon. And I'll add it just below this. Let's do some settings here. Let's choose the main container here. Go to layouts, scroll down, and just make it to the center and align it to the center here. Now quickly, what I'll do is I'll sort it out and come back. Okay, so now you guys can see that I have added a text here. Simply scroll down and an icon of down arrow. What I'll do is I'll click this icon here and duplicate it. Okay, so we have two search icons. Let's change the text to scroll up and the icon to up position. Okay, so we'll change the arrow here. Okay, looks good. Now in between these two, I'll be making my main container. Click this plus sign, add a direction column again, and let's start making the stack card scrolling. Okay guys, so now what I'll do is I'll choose this container. I'll change its content width to full width, min height to VH, so that we have the equal container size like these two. Okay, let's change it to 100. Okay, looks good. Now let's add a container in this container here like this. Okay, and what I'll do is I'll add one container in this. I'll change its width to percentage and I'll make it 50%. Okay, and let's open Navigator so that it gets easier for us to make. Okay, so I'll duplicate it. What I'll do is I'll choose this outer container in which we have these two containers here. Here you can see direction. You can change its direction to horizontal like this. Okay, and we have one container here and one container here of equal width. Okay, I'll change its min height to VH first. And then I'll make it 100. This looks pretty cool now. What I'll do is I'll add some items in it. Let's add a background color first. Go to style here from the background type. Choose color palette and give it a nice background. Let's give it a dark black background. Okay, this looks good. Here, I'll be dragging a heading like this. And after the heading, some text. Below this, and a button. Okay, this looks good. Okay, now I'll choose this inner container here, which we have added. I'll change its content width to full width. Okay, and I'll change its width to px first, and then I'll make it 350, and here min height to 350 here, so that we get a cart texture. Okay, now choose this outer container here. Okay, and go to layouts, scroll down, and justify to the center and align it to the center. Okay, this looks good. Now what I'll do is I'll choose this inner container, go to style, and give my card a nice background color. Let's choose red first. Okay, this looks good. Layouts. Okay guys, now you can see that I've added some heading here, some text, and a button here. And I've just created a dummy template so that you guys can see how you can make the design. Okay, now I'll be making my main stack card scrolling effect here in this container. So first of all, what I'll do is I'll choose this icon here from the left side and drag a container widget. Okay, so now I'll change its width to px350 here. And min height to 350 here. Okay, now I'll choose this inner container here, which we have added. I'll change its content width to full width. Okay, and I'll change its width to px first, and then I'll make it 350, and here min height to 350 here, so that we get a card texture. Okay, now choose this outer container here. Okay, and go to layouts, scroll down, and justify to the center and align it to the center. Okay, this looks good. Now what I'll do is I'll choose this inner container, go to style, and give my card a nice background color. Let's choose red first. Okay, this looks good. Okay, layouts. Okay, now in style here, go down, go to border here, and you can give it some radius. Let's make it to 30. Okay, looks good. I'll make it 35. Okay, this looks good. So this is my first card which I'll be designing. Let's design it first. Okay, now let's design our card. Click this plus sign here and let's search for a post info first. From the left side, drag it here. Okay, so what I want is just the date. So we have got the date here. Okay, next what I want is a heading widget. Let's drag a heading widget below this. Looks good. Some text. let's search for a text editor and drag it like this, and another heading like this. Let's just sort it out and see how our card looks. Okay guys, now our first card is ready. So what I'll do is I'll check its responsiveness. Go to responsive mode from down here, her left side. Click responsive mode here. Okay, here let's see how it looks in tablet. Let's reduce its size. Choose this container here. Go to layouts, and instead of 350, let's make it 250 by 250, and let's reduce this font sizes, this huge font sizes. Go to typography and change its size. Okay, it looks perfect. Let's make it 30 pixel. Looks good. And you can change the font here. Poppins. Okay, so now this looks good. What I'll do is I'll do the settings for the mobile portrait as well. Go to mobile portrait here, scroll down, choose this container here. Okay, and again we'll change its width to 250. Okay, now it looks good. Let's get back to the desktop version. Okay, let's change its typography. It's poppin', looks good. And Alex Wilson, let's change this to Poppins as well. Okay, now here we need to change its position. To change its position, we need to go to advanced here and scroll down more, and here you can see position. You need to change its position to absolute. Okay, scroll down and change its offset value to none and offset here to none, so that it gets back to its original place. Now what I'll do is I'll duplicate it here. Duplicate it. Okay, let's open Navigator here. Okay, so we have two such containers. What I'll do is I'll click this I here so that only one container is visible. Now let's work on this container here. I'll change the background color here. Go to style from the left side, change its background color. Let's go for a bluish one. Okay, this looks good. Now I'll change the text. Okay, so this is the second card which I have made. Similarly, let's open Navigator again. Okay, we can duplicate this card here. And let's make this card invisible as well. So we have two containers which will be invisible. Okay, let's work on this container here. This is the third card which I'll be making. Okay guys, so now you can see that I've made four such cards here with the method I have told you guys. Let's open Navigator first so that it's easy for us to select the cards. Okay, so these are our cards, and okay, go up, and this is the container in which we have all our cards here. Okay, so what I'll do is we'll go to advanced here, scroll down, and in CSS class you need to type a class which I'll also mention in the description below. MDW stacked dash cards. Okay, and here the main container here, go to advanced, scroll down, and type this CSS class MDW-stacked-card-area. Okay, looks perfect. Okay, so now in this container here, the second container, go to advanced where we added the CSS class MDW stack card area. Go to custom CSS and type this code here, which I'll also mention in the description below so that you guys can copy paste it. This is done. What I'll do is I'll add a custom code here. So let's open this. Okay, let's open this. Okay, so here in Elementor you can see an option given custom code. Click this and you can add new code here. So let's add a code here. Custom code is, let's name it as tag. Okay, and let's add this code here, which I'll also mention in the description below, so don't worry about the code snippet. Okay, so you can add condition. Let's click publish. Okay, so the code snippet is added. If they ask you for the condition, you can tag it to the page where, if they have given us the condition option, you can tag it to the page where the you have made the card slider. Okay, let's go back and check if our card is working properly or not. Okay, let's click publish here. Okay guys, now you can see that I've added this code snippet here and I've updated it. If they asked you for a condition, you can add a condition and tag it to the page where you have made the card scrolling. Okay, so this is where we have created our card scrolling effect slider. Let's preview how it looks. Okay, so this is what we have made here. Let's get it loaded first, scroll down. Okay, let's go down and see how it looks. Looks very beautiful. Okay, this is perfect. When we scroll down, the card slides to upside. And when we scroll up, it comes back to the place where it was. I hope you like my tutorial. If you want more such videos, please don't forget to subscribe my channel, hit the like button and comment below so that I can make such beautiful videos again. Thank you.